better place. We have 40 days to make our world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make our world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make our world a better place. By the help of God, to make our world a better place.
Hello students, hope you are okay, and today I want to take you through a topic, international trade. This is basically a trade between two or more countries. If it involves two countries, then we call it a bilateral trade, and if it involves more than two countries, we will call it multilateral trade. And we have several advantages of international trade, which may include a wide variety of goods and services. We also will get to use the things that we don't produce. We also have a development of different countries because the flow of commodities, and lastly, movements of factors of production, which are very important in production of goods and services in either of the countries. Anything that has got a disadvantage, occasionally do have disadvantages. And some of the disadvantages of international trade include collapse of local industries. For example, if we are importing second-hand clothes or first-hand clothes from other countries, the local industries that produce clothes will collapse. We also have importation of harmful products. Some of the imports may be harmful to the society that is here in the country that is importing. We also have the importation of inflation and acquisition of bad culture. And lastly, we may have unfavorable balance of trade. After that, we want to see what we call terms of trade. Terms of trade is simply the comparison between the imports and the exports. And we have a formula for it. Terms of trade, which is abbreviated as TOT, will be gotten by price index of exports, price index of exports over price index of imports. How do you get to know the price index of imports, and how do you get to know the price index of imports? For you to know the price index of export, which will abbreviate as PIE, price index of export, you will get it through a formula. That is, you will compare the average prices of exports in the current year versus the average prices of the imports in the same year. So for example, we may have Kenya and China exporting. So you will have in 2014 and in 2015, China, somewhere Kenya. You have a table. So we will be having imports and exports here. Imports and exports. So Kenya imported 1,000, exported to 2,000. China imported, these are imports, and these are exports. So China imported 2,000 from Kenya, and exported 1,000. So this is the current year. This is the import, and this is the okay. This is the import. This is the export. So you will compare what you did in the current year and then in the previous year. So we have a price index of exports over price index of imports. That is for the terms of trade. Then let's see what we call the reasons for different or unfavorable terms of trade. We also have nature of goods, natural factors, and also trade restrictions. Let's see what balance of trade entails. Something called balance of trade. This one was terms of trade, but now balance of trade, which is abbreviated as BOP. How do we calculate balance of trade? Balance of trade is gotten by comparing the physical imports and the physical exports. Balance of trade can be either at equilibrium or disequilibrium. When it is disequilibrium, it may be good for your country or bad for your country. Which situation is good and which situation is bad? It is good when you are exporting more and importing less. Therefore, the value is more than 100% of what you are getting. And it is bad when you are importing more and exporting less. We also have different ways of correcting balance of payments. Balance of payment, disequilibrium. One of them is devaluating your currency. Second is encouraging long-term flow of exports. Then we have a decrease in the volume of imports and increase in the volume of export, as well as restricting capital flow from your country to other countries. So we also have several terms used in sales, international sales. One of them is FOR, free on rail. We also have DD. We also have FAS, which basically means free at maybe the docking place. Then we also have documents used. One of them is letter of inquiry, and we have order of indent. You'll be able to see how they can be used differently. Let's move to international financial institutions. For international financial institution, we have a financial institution. We have a World Bank. We have IMF, International Monetary Fund, IMF. We also have African Development Bank, and we have African Development Fund. World Bank was formed so many years ago, and it mainly facilitates the loaning of countries at a lower interest rate. We also have IMF, International Monetary Fund, which is basically meant to be the bank of all banks in the world, or for the member states. IMF's main function is to regulate the foreign exchange as well as giving loans. We also have African Development Bank, which was formed to facilitate the movement of resources or investment in Africa. We also have African Development Fund, which is majorly funding the research on education and other things that may include the calamities and ways appropriate, more appropriate ways of solving them. And I hope you enjoyed the lesson, and see you next time. Thank you.